The Delhi government has closed all schools for the next 3 days and shut down all construction and demolitions for 5 days due to alarming levels of air pollution. Addressing the media after holding a cabinet meeting, Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal said, landfill sites, fires will be bulldozed and transportation of fly ash will be stopped for 10 days. Meanwhile, Delhi residents held a protest at Jantar Mantar against the government's ineffectiveness in addressing the issue. The centre has stepped in to mitigate the threat of smog and rising levels of pollution in Delhi. Environment Ministry has called meeting of all neighbouring states tomorrow. Delhi Lieutenant Governor Najib Jung has also convened a high-level meeting tomorrow over the issue. Union Environment Minister has said, instead of playing a blame game and politicising the issue, it should be dealt with appropriately with responsibility. In Jammu and Kashmir, 2 army jawans have been killed and 3 others, 2 soldiers and a woman, have been injured as Pakistani army opened fire in a bid to facilitate 2 infiltration bids along the line of control in Krishna Ghati and Poonch sectors. The Indian Army said that while the infiltration bids were foiled, it has also inflicted heavy damage to several Pakistani posts across the line of control in Poonch sector. BJP's Parivartan Yatra has seen huge turnout in Lalitpur Jhansi in Uttar Pradesh. Addressing the rally, Rajnath Singh said, SP and BSP have done nothing for Bundelkhand region in the last 15 years. Amit Shah has said, if BJP is voted to power, Uttar Pradesh will emerge as the most prosperous state in India. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said research in agro-biodiversity is very important to ensure global food, nutrition and environment security. Inaugurating the first International Agro-Biodiversity Congress in New Delhi, Prime Minister Modi said research needs to be done and best practices need to be noted and curated. Information and Broadcasting Minister M. Venkaiah Naidu has said information with confirmation in media is important besides speed. Inaugurating the orientation program for Urdu journalists in Hyderabad, Naidu said the government is committed to freedom of press, but it has to be under self-regulation and evoke healthy debate. The Information and Broadcasting Ministry is stressing on producing local programs in the Northeast. Minister of State for Information and Broadcasting Colonel Rajwardhan Singh Rathore has said that the Arun Prabha channel will start soon in the Northeast and added that Doordarshan has started to work in this direction. The minister said this while speaking to Prasar Bharati in Guwahati. Aam Aadmi Party MLA Rituraj Govind has been arrested on charges of apprehension of breach of peace in Outer Delhi's Kirari area before Chhath Puja, making him the 15th party legislator to be apprehended. Police said Section 144 of the CRPC was imposed in the Ghat area from yesterday morning in view of the Chhath Puja, and the MLA had allegedly violated the order. In the wake of fresh attacks on Hindus in Bangladesh, External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj has directed the Indian High Commissioner in Dhaka to convey to Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina India's grave concern over safety and security of the community in that country. In fresh attacks on Hindus in Bangladesh, unidentified miscreants set ablaze houses of some of them in Central District, where several places of worship of the minority community were vandalized a few days ago. Defence, security and trade relations will top the agenda of talks between Prime Minister Narendra Modi and his British counterpart Theresa May during her 3-day India visit. Accompanied by International Trade Secretary Liam Fox and International Trade Minister Greg Hands, May is leading a 40-member business delegation. Defence and security will be an important part of the bilateral discussions. India will push the agenda for sustainable lifestyle at the Global Climate Conference beginning in the Moroccan city of Marrakesh tomorrow. At the 12-day conference, nations will continue their work on strengthening the global response to the threat of climate change. The focus will be on enhancing ambition, promoting implementation and providing support. In Iraq, suicide bombings killed at least 18 people and wounded more than 30 in 2 cities north of Baghdad. According to police, one bomber detonated an explosive-rigged vehicle at the southern entrance of Tikrit, while the other blew up an ambulance in Samarra. Iraqi forces are fighting to retake Mosul from Islamic State, the jihadist group's last major urban stronghold in the country. There was no immediate claim of responsibility for the attacks. Democratic presidential candidate Hillary Clinton holds a 5-point lead over Republican Donald Trump in the latest Washington Post ABC tracking poll. In the Post ABC poll released, Clinton led Trump by 47% to 44%. Clinton had an advantage in affirmative support, the poll said, with 55% of backers saying they are mainly supporting her compared with 43% for Trump voters. In boxing, Manny Pacquiao reclaimed the World Boxing Organization welterweight title for the third time. The 37-year-old Filipino pugilist, who had announced his retirement 7 months ago, was declared the winner with unanimous decision after he defeated American Jesse Vargas in his comeback fight at Las Vegas. Pacquiao knocked Vargas down in the second round en route to a superb victory. Chhath Puja is being celebrated in several states today. The puja, celebrated on the 6th day of Kartik month, is dedicated to the sun god for supporting life on earth and ensuring prosperity and happiness in life.